हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल। आई एम अंकिता भगत, योर साइंस टीचर इन सहजानंद इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल इट नाठेज। सो इन आवर प्रीवियस सेशन वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द सोइल प्रिपरेशन, राइट? एंड इन दिस वीडियो और इन दिस सेशन वी डिस्कस अबाउट द अदर एग्रीकल्चर प्रैक्टिसेस, right? I hope you all are see the part one properly. Now let us start with sowing. So the next agriculture practices is sowing. So sowing, it means to sow the seeds with the help of tractor or the traditional tools, right? So it is the important part of crop production. So again, it is the important part of crop production, right? So before sowing seeds, make sure, and mostly the farmer take a clean and healthy seeds for the crop, right? So there are the two methods for the sowing seeds. So there are the two methods for sowing seeds. The first one is the traditional tool and the second one is the seed drill. So seed drill is the new technique nowadays, right? But in traditional tool, in our ancient time, the tool is used traditionally for sowing the seeds. Now let us see the structure of the traditional seeds. So that is given in figure. So the traditional tools are look like a funnel. So here funnel is given to you. Here funnel is given to you, right? The tool is used traditionally for sowing seeds, shaped like a funnel. So the funnel is given. In this funnel, the seeds are filled or put into the funnel. Then after, they pass through the two or three pipes having the sharp ends. And these ends burst into the soils and place into the soils, right? So these are the traditional tools. But nowadays, technology is developed. So that's why nowadays, the seed drill technique is used. So the seed drill technique, which is connect with tractor, it is used for sowing with the help of tractor. So it consumes the time and labor also. Now let us see the structure of seed drill. So see, here is the structure of the seed drill. So in that, the iron tube with the funnel at the top. So these are the iron tube. And here is the funnel. So these are the funnel at the top. And seeds are put into the funnel and then released in the soil forms. So if you put the seed in the funnel, then after the seed is released into the soil furrows, right? So these sow seeds are uniformly at the equal distance and the same depth, right? So it ensures that seed get covered by the soil after sowing. And moreover, it protect the seeds from being eaten by the birds. It protect by the birds. And it also avoid the overcrowding of plants. That's why the plants get nutrients and minerals and sunlight properly, right? So these are the sowing seeds. So here seed drill, the traditional tools are used for sowing seeds. Now the next is adding manure and fertilizer. So adding manure and fertilizer. So these are the another agriculture practices. So what are the adding manure and fertilizer, right? So the substance which are added to the soil in the form of nutrients for the healthy growth of plants is called manure and fertilizer. Again I repeat you, the substance which are added to the soil in the form of nutrients for the healthy growth of plant is called nutrition, manure and fertilizer, right? So what is manure? So see, listen carefully. Like other plants or crop plants also obtain their mineral and nutrients from the soil. So other plants and crop plants, they both, or any other plants, absorb the nutrients from the soil, right? So continuously growing a crop in the field causes the deficient of a mineral and nutrients in the soils. So continuous growing the crop in this soil, so after few years there are the deficiency of the nutrients and the mineral in the soil. So the manure, so that's why the manure is added to the soil to make up for the deficiency of the minerals, nutrients. So that's why manure added to recover the deficiency of mineral and nutrients, right? So this process is called manuring, and manure is made up of cow dung, urine and other waste and the plant residue. Got it my point? Now the next, sometime what happens? The soil becomes deficient in the particular mineral and nutrients. So soil become deficient in a particular mineral and deficient mineral and nutrients. So it happens when same crop is grown in the same field again and again. So the many year, if you grow the same crop in the same field again and again, at that time some deficiency of a nutrition, the particular deficiency in the soils. For example, the particular crop takes the more phosphate. If the particular crop, suppose some crops takes the phosphate from the soil, so is grown in the field every year. Grown in the field every year, the soil will become deficient in the phosphorus nutrition. So phosphorus nutrition is the particular nutrition. So these particular deficiencies are made up by to adding chemical substances in the soil. So this chemical substances is called fertilizer, right? So the fertilizer are made up by the chemicals which are rich in the particular nutrients. Got it my point? So how, here question again, how are they different from the manure? The fertilizer is different from the manure, but how? See, the manure is the natural, but the fertilizer is the man-made, right? So the fertilizer are produced in a factory, but the manure are produced in a field. So see how they are different from manure. So the fertilizer are produced in a factories, and some example of factories are Some example of fertilizers are urea, ammonium sulfate, superphosphate, potash, NPK. And the full form is nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. And one more is DAP. DAP, the full form is diammonium phosphate. So these are the example of fertilizer. So here one activity is given to you. See activity 1.2. In activity 1.2, that is given, take a mung or a gram seeds and germinate them. So first you have to take a mung or, so do this activity at your home, right? So take a mung or a gram seeds and germinate them. Now select the three equal glasses or vessels and seedling into the glasses. Now take a three empty glass and mark them A, B, C. So in a glass A, you have to add a little amount of soil. With the soil, mix a manure. Is the natural and it is made from the cow dung, right? And in a glass B, put the same amount of soil and mix with a little urea in that. And again in a glass C, take the same amount of soil and no need to add the manure or fertilizer in that. So you don't have anything add in that, right? Now pour the same amount of water in each glass and plant the seedling in them. Now keep them in the safe places where the sunlight is present. Now after 7 to 10 days, after few days you have to observe what happened. So in figure number 1.3b, you can clearly to observe that the plant growth of A is far. A is better, but the plant growth of B is fastest as compared to A. But in a glass A, we have to add manure. In glass B, we have to add urea, right? So the growth of plant B is fastest and the A is better, but in the glass C, the growth is slowest, right? So here we conclude that the manure and the fertilizer is required, is essential for the better growth of crop or any other plants. Got it my point? See, the fertilizer and the manure is required for the plant, essential for the better growth of plant, better output of the crop. But excessive use, here the excessive use, but the excessive use of the fertilizer made the soil less fertile. Made the soil less fertile, and fertilizers have also become the source of water pollution. But when you use the excessive use, the more amount of use the fertilizer, it also get the soil less fertile. So use the required amount only, right? Now the fertilizer have also become a source of water pollution. So therefore, in order to maintain the fertility of soil, we have to substitute a fertilizer with the organic manure. So we have to added a manure with the fertilizer, right? And one more, the soil replenished method is used. So the another method is the crop rotation is essential, and if possible the use of manure improve it. Improve the soil texture, and the water retaining capacity, right? So the method is use the manure and the crop rotation. So mostly farmer in northern India, they use the growth legumes and as a fodder in a one season and the wheat in the next season. So these help in the replenishment of the soil with nitrogen, right? So in your previous class you learned that the rhizobium bacteria, so the rhizobium bacteria has convert the atmospheric nitrogen into the usable form of nitrogen, and then after plant absorbs the nitrogen along with water. So in your previous class you already learn about that, right? So here difference is given. So the difference between fertilizer and manure, here given that the difference between fertilizers and manure. So we already learn about that. Again we discuss. So here first one is given, fertilizer is the main inorganic soil. It inorganic matter, right? So the fertilizer is the man-made or a inorganic. It is made up with the chemical, that's why. But here is the manure. So manure is a natural substance obtained by the decomposition of cow dung and the plant residues. Again, the fertilizer is prepared in factories, but the manure is prepared in field, as I told you. Then the one more point in that, fertilizer does not provide any humus to the soil. So humus is the upper layer of the soil on earth crust, right? It fertilizes the soil, but in the fertilizer does not provide the any humus to the soil. But in manure provide the lot of humus. It provide the lot of humus to the soil. So the next point is, fertilizer are very rich in plant nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, but the manure is relatively less rich in the plant nutrients. So the fertilizer supply only the particular nutrients, but the manure supply the all required nutrients to the plants. And the growth of the manure is slower than fertilizer, and the growth of the fertilizer is faster than manure. So these are the difference between fertilizer and manure. I hope you all are clear about the fertilizer and manure. Got it? So here some advantages is given of manure. So advantages of the manure, let us discuss. The organic manure is considered the better than fertilizer. This is because, but obvious, the organic manure is better than the fertilizer, because the organic manure do not pollute the soil or water also, right? So point is given, it enhance the water holding capacity and soil. It improve the water holding capacity. Now next, it makes the soil porous due to which exchange the gases become easily. So in the manure, the air passages are formed, that why the air can passes easily between the soil particles, right? It increase the number of friendly microbes like earthworms and all. and it improves the texture of the soil. It also improves the texture of soil. Now students, next we have irrigation. So irrigation it means the supply of water to the crop at the regular interval is called irrigation, right? But the irrigation, the time and frequency, both are different from crop to crop, season to season, and soil to soil. For example, in summer, the frequency of water is higher. It means in the summer season, the crop absorbs the water more as compared to winter and monsoon, right? So that's why the frequency and time both are different from season to season, soil to soil, and crop to crop. Got it, my point? Now, you know very well that water is essential for the living organism, right? For the proper growth and development. And water is absorbed by the plant root, and along with the water, they also absorb the minerals and nutrients. And you know very well the plant contains nearly 90% of water. And in the dry condition, so under the dry condition, the seeds cannot germinate properly. That's why the water is essential for the plants and the living organism also, right? And moreover, it also maintains the moisture of the soil for the healthy crop growth, right? That's why in a field you have to be watered regularly. So in the field you have to do watered regularly, right? So there are the different sources of water, and there are the different sources of irrigations, right? So the sources of water for irrigation is lake, pond, wells, tube wells, canal, etc. So these are the different sources for irrigations. And again, they have a different method for the irrigation. So the traditional method and modern method. So let us discuss the traditional method and modern method. See the methods of irrigation, right? So the first one is the traditional and the modern method. So in traditional method, they have four types. The first one is the mot and pulley. Second one is the chain pump. Third one is the Dackley system, and the fourth one is the Rahat system. So one by one I explain you in detail in further chapter. But in modern irrigation, they have only two types, the sprinkler system and the drip irrigation system, right? So these are the methods of irrigation. But student, our session is over here, and I will explain you in the next sessions the methods of irrigation in details. So I will explain you the methods of irrigation in next session. I hope you all are understood very well. Thank you. Have a nice day.